What I'd like to talk about this morning is how we educate athletes to open up their back against their legs early in the stroke. Often we see athletes where they drive with their legs and then they open up. What we want to do is we want to have it happen as a sequence where they all work together. So the shoulders, the lower back in particular, the back and then the shoulders work against the legs and then the arms finish the stroke off. And they all sort of happen together in one sequential movement. So what we're looking to do is we'll come into the catch, and once we're at the catch, then we put the blade in, get ourselves connected. Then we want to start, as we get connected with the water, we want to start opening up with our core and our lower body. So the sequence of events, coming into the catch, turn the core on, lower core, so that we're very well connected within our body, get the blade in the water, get connected to the water, and then start to open up. And so what we're going to demonstrate here on an ergo is how to train on an ergo that opening up technique. And you may find when you start to do this with athletes that they end up feeling very tight in the lower part of their back. Now probably that's an indication, if they're doing the technique correctly, it's an indication that they're not strong enough in that area. So we suggest talk to a physio, talk to a weights person, and get some exercises done that you can do every few days during the week to make the back stronger so they can do this properly. There's little point in doing it properly only for a few strokes and then reverting back to the old habit, and do it properly all the time and therefore build the strength in the right particular part muscle groups in order to make sure that the athlete can. So let's demonstrate it on the ergo. So what we're going to demonstrate here is the owner's going to demonstrate on the ergo the technique where the leg drive happens first and then the body opens up afterwards, which is not what we're trying to advocate. It's just I'd like to show you what it looks like when we're doing it the other way. What we'd like to do now is Siona will demonstrate the technique where we start to open up earlier, so the body starts to open up against the legs as the stroke gets underway. So the part of the body that we're trying to in order to do this, what you need to do is you need to turn your core on really solidly just before the catch, so that when you do start to open up, you're very well connected. We don't want to have connection through the shoulders, it's all about connection through the lower body. So what we're looking to do is turn this part of the core on and drive straight back through the hips with that plane rather than up in the upper body. So Sione will now demonstrate the technique where we have it, so we're opening the body against the legs. Remember, important to turn that core on before you start.
So when I'm rowing, feeling connected through my core of my lower back, and I'm just trying to get it connected earlier in the stroke, it feels a lot stronger and it feels like the stroke flows a lot more smoothly towards the finish because the lower body is connected better to the legs and the trunk and the legs.
So one of the things that we're trying to do with this technique is get connected first, of course, and then open up with the lower back and the body and the legs all in one sequential movement through to the finish, a smooth process through to the finish. Part of this means that you'll get a sensation of feeling lighter on the seat. Now you want to get yourself lifted off the seat essentially with that power of the lower back and the body all working together. But you want to make sure that only happens after you're connected to the water. So you need to wait for the connection. Once you've connected, then you then want to drive powerfully through the lower core and the lower back and the legs, and you'll feel that you get lighter on the seat. So there's this sensation of lifting yourself off the seat as you get through towards the finish, then you come back onto the seat. So you'll be able to feel that you're light on the seat when you're in the drive phase, and then you come back onto the seat at the finish. If you open with your shoulders instead, what happens, that tends to push you onto the seat harder. So there's a real difference in feeling between lifting yourself off the seat with your core and your lower back compared to pushing yourself onto your seat by opening your shoulders. So if we demonstrate here with Siona, if Siona lifts the shoulders here, then you can see part of the force is coming down into the seat. If instead drive straight out through the hips, then you'll see that it's possible to lift off the seat and lighten the load on the boat. So what we're trying to do here, first thing is that we'll demonstrate which part of the body needs to be switched on. So Siona turns the lower core on and pushes against me. Now if she pushes against me, then you'll see that she comes up off the seat. Now if you instead pull with your shoulders and try and come off the seat, really difficult to get off the seat if you're using your shoulders. So what we want to do, lower core, turn the lower core on and have the athlete push against you. Then go with them a little bit with your hands and they'll feel themselves come back onto the seat again towards the finish of the stroke. So ask the athlete. So what we want to do is ask the athlete to turn the lower core on and try to feel themselves getting lighter on the seat and going back on the other when they get towards the finish. To make it dramatic, they have to try really hard, but it's really the concept that we're trying to get across and the sense of feeling that you get in your bottom when you find that you're actually getting lighter on the seat and coming back onto the seat towards the finish. What we also find with this technique is that when the athlete's out in the boat, they'll feel like they're lifting their shoulders. But if they're doing it correctly by using the lower core, then they won't actually be lifting their shoulders. So by all means, film them out on the water, ask them to lift their, if they get connected correctly and they're driving correctly through the hips like that, ask them to try and do it as hard as they can and see, and they'll feel like their shoulders are lifting, but in reality when you watch the footage, they're not. They're just well connected right the way through the body.